Hi everyone, we are in Turkey. My name is Osman Güneri and I am a shepherd. Actually, they call me also Turkish cowboy. And we are right now in Eskişehir region. Eskişehir region is in between Istanbul and Ankara. You may say between Istanbul and Ankara about 450 kilometers. So we are right in the middle and south part of it. So these are Anatolian lands. As you can see, vast grasslands here. Our subject is sheep, and we're gonna talk about sheep. And you can see is the herd here. It's a kıvırcık herd. I will talk about this herd in another program as well. But this herd has been grazing all night long. Now they are almost going back to their barn because they have been grazing all night long. And also you can look at there is a donkey. Donkey is very important for shepherd. Donkey carries all the needs of a shepherd in Turkey. You cannot think of a herd, flock going on its own. There must be a shepherd because we have predators. What are the predators? Predators are the wolves. The wolves are the herd is saved by the dogs. There are almost 10 dogs in a herd. This is this flock is around 400 sheep, 400 to 500 sheep. So I have here a shepherd stick. This shepherd stick is made of dogwood. This is the typical shepherd stick. And this guy, the gentleman over there, is the owner of the flock. His name is Emre Tınaz. And I have a friend who is actually taking our pictures at the moment. He's a veterinarian, Hasan Sofuoğlu. So we are in the middle of it. We came here about 4 o'clock in the morning. We have been grazing the sheep. Now it's almost finished. We are going to have a shepherd breakfast this morning. But what you see here on the grassland is like you may think of it like a range. It's a natural grass, and you can see many varieties of grass and herbs you can see in this land. And really, the sheep you see here is one of the oldest ancient sheep. It's called kıvırcık in Turkish, but actually during Ottoman Empire this kıvırcık was taken to French people, I think, and I declare from here that this kıvırcık sheep is actually lagun. Lagun comes from kıvırcık. Lagun breed of sheep is the sheep that make French people make Roquefort cheese. Roquefort cheese made of lagun sheep milk. So this is the same original sheep. But of course, when you look at it, there is a lagun breeding association and they have improved it so much. Now lagun sheep production is quite high. Milk production is quite high. In Turkey, this version, kıvırcık version, is only kept mainly for meat. But if you go to some areas, they feed the lambs. I mean, the sheep looks after the lamb about 75 to 90 days. After 90 days, they start milking the kıvırcık sheep, and they get about 100 liters of milk, another maybe 60 days to 100 days. So it's at about a liter of milk. So you can say that actually it's a good milk sheep, this breed. So I just wanted to show you about this sheep and these lands. And now we are going to have a breakfast. I want you to see the breakfast as well. So let's go and have a breakfast. Now we are going to have a shepherd's breakfast all together. But I want to explain you something. This is called kepenek. Look, this is called kepenek. So the shepherd lives inside of this. So when he's going to sleep in the night, if it snows or anything happens, the shepherd wears this. It is worn like that. It's very hot. And how they make it, I will also try to explain to you. This is called kepenek. And believe me, even minus 10 degrees Celsius, you can be inside of this and you would never feel cold. This is how it's worn. And usually, shepherds sleeps like this. Look, you can fall down and you can sleep in it like that. You can actually, inside, you can cover your head, and it's a small tent. So this is how it's worn. And what it's made of, is it's made of wool. But it's like a real cowboy hat, if you know about it, how the process works. This is beaten up all the time. Beaten up and it's squeezed. So the rain, snow, nothing can go inside of it. Now, of course, it's becoming daytime and we are going to have breakfast. So we make it like we are going to sit on it. It's a cushion. Also, this is also kepenek. Of course, this is my hat. I have to take my hat. And this is the real tea, Turkish legendary tea. If you come to Turkey, you need to drink this tea. What we do is, we have water in this, and the teapot is this. So, according to how a person likes tea, we mix the tea with the water. This is how we drink it in Turkey. So, there are some books about it. It's a cup of tea. You English call it cup of tea. We say bir bardak çay. This is very, very important for us. Now, we have the bread, we have the cheese. All the cheese are made of sheep's milk. This is important. It's not a roquefort cheese, but it's made of kıvırcık milk, which is the version of lakun, as we say. Now, thanks to Emre, he invited me over here, the real shepherd. Emre, teşekkür ederiz sana.
Teşekkür ederiz.
This is our donkey. Donkey, as I said, is very important.
Hanım, çok önemli.
Donkey takes the herd with it. You know, always the sheep follow the donkey. And also, with inside the donkey, you carry all the lambs, the gun. The gun is needed not to kill any animal, don't forget, just to scare the wolves. This is important. This is for water, everything, and also kepenek is carried in this. Everything is carried in this. So they are the friend of the shepherd. So it's also a friend of us. Let's give a kiss to this donkey, which is very nice, lovely,
cuddly.
Yes, if when the shepherd gets really tired, he says, we sit down on it a little bit because they are pretty strong. And this is part of our life. Yes, this is the shepherd's life. I was trying to explain to you. This is Turkish shepherd's life. This is how we live. This is how we take care of our sheep. It's not like you leave the sheep on its own, but it has to be with us all the time. So this was my first English version of trying to make a program with you, and hopefully from now on we'll be explaining about Turkey Turkish sheep and goat business, how it goes, and also we'll be taking some pictures in other countries as well. I hope you like it. If you like this program, please don't forget to join my YouTube. And thank you for listening us, and especially to herd holders and to shepherds all around the world. May your goats and sheep be healthy. May God bless you all. Thank you and bye.